Good morning, children. Children, welcome to the session of computer. And today we will be studying chapter 3, which is the operating system. Right? So, firstly, we should know what is an operating system. In simple words, see, children, you can understand operating system to be a set of programs. It is a set of programs through which a computer basically operates. It is just like life of a computer. If there is no operating system, computer will not work. Okay, now let us see the introduction. An operating system is the most important software that runs on a computer. It is the set of programs that manages the computer memory, process and all of the software and hardware. Without an operating system, a computer is useless. It allows you to communicate with the computer, to act as a medium of communication between user and the computer. Basically, you can call it is the operating system which ensures everything is working properly in a computer. Unless and until you don't have a proper operating system, the computer is not going to work properly and efficiently. Right? That is the main purpose of a operating system. There are so many operating systems in this world. Right? But not all operating systems are compatible everywhere. Right? So people use different operating system as per the need and requirements of the computer. Now, types of computer operating system: single user operating system, then there is multi-user operating system, both are there. When single user operating system, it allows only one person, see, this is a key point here, it allows only one person to work on a time. So, and the best example is MS-DOS. If there is MS-DOS in a computer, only one person can work. Then there are multi-user operating systems. It allows many people to work, right? Please remember, for multi-user, it allows many people to work on different computers that are connected to the main computer through a network. Now, where many people should be connected, and that is the main computer, right? That is the main computer. With this, things it is connected, and every main computer, every other computer is connected. Now, Windows and Linux are the examples of multi-user operating system, right? Windows and Linux. Windows, we all know. Linux is basically used in government institutes. Multi-user operating system is used in big organizations like office, railway stations, schools and airport, right? Because there are so many places where work is going on at the same time. Now we come to the difference between DOS. DOS is a single user operating system, and Windows is a multi-user operating system. DOS, only one user can work at a time. In Windows, many users can work. In DOS, you need to type the command. In Windows, there are ready-to-made commands, right, in the form of menu, and it can be applied by a mouse click. We need mouse for Windows. The three most common operating system used for personal computer are Microsoft Windows, very, very common, Apple, Mac OS, and X, and Linux. Right, these are the some of the very basic operating systems which are there. Right, now let us learn about the Windows operating system. MS Windows is one of the most popular operating system, and it is very easy to use. Why it is easy to use? Because it is very common. That is why it is used most by most of the people around the world. Windows is one of the latest Windows. Windows 8 is the latest versions of MS Windows. However, Windows 7 is widely used. Right? See, this is the screen or logo of Windows 7. When you switch on to the computer, this one, and you switch on to the computer, after a few seconds, MS Windows operating system gets loaded in the computer memory. This process is called booting. While booting, the picture of the window logos appears on the screen, just like the one which I have circled. After few more seconds, a blue screen with small picture on it appears. The screen is called desktop and the small picture is known as icons. Right? So this thing appears on the screen. Now what is a desktop? Desktop is the first screen that appears after the booting process. Right? As you have many things in your study table, similarly a computer desktop contains many items to work from. See, this is a desktop screen here. It looks like this. And here, see, there are many, many small, small things. These are the icons clicking on which you can work. Now, let us discuss some of them. Icons. Icon is a small picture that appears on the desktop screen. Each icon represents a file, folder, or a program. You can operate open icons by double clicking on them. Some of the icons are computer, recycle bin, documents, and network. So these are some of the important icons which by default are present on a computer, right? आप जब भी एक नया कंप्यूटर खरीदोगे तब भी ये जो है चारों के चारों ये उसमें आपको मिलेंगे. कंप्यूटर. दिस आइकॉन डिस्प्लेज द कंटेंट ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर. इट डिस्प्लेज ऑल द अवेलेबल ड्राइव्स एंड देन डॉक्यूमेंट. इट गिव्स अ लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल द डॉक्यूमेंट्स इनसाइड. देन देयर इज रिसाइकल बिन. इट डिस्प्लेज द लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल द डिलीटेड आइटम. व्हेन वी डिलीट अ फाइल ऑफ फोल्डर इट गोज इनटू डिलीट रिसाइकल बिन. इट एक्ट्स एज अ डस्टबिन फॉर द कंप्यूटर. Just to delete the file, we need to delete it, erase it from the bin. Right? Now, network. It helps us to connect with the computer with the other computers. Right? So, there are so many things like we need to connect. Suppose we have to do it with, we have to connect a mobile to a computer. It will be done through network. Now, there are some terms here. First is operating system. System that is required to run a computer is called operating system. Single user, only which allows only one person. Multi-user, it allows many person. Network, it helps us to connect a computer with other computers. So I stop here. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did in making it. Until we meet again, it's a goodbye.